Hey, you beautiful people. I hope you're doing okay. I'm Aditi Gupta, the blogger of Calm Insights, and today I'm going to talk about body shaming and use of cosmetic products to look, you know, to adopt the way in socially acceptable ways in which you must look. So there is so much a lot of fault, multi-layered fault in the system, which we have unfortunately internalized in so many ways, so much so that we don't even question whether, you know, whether we want to, you know, apply makeup for, you know, for the reason that we want to, or because everyone else does, and if you don't do, you will stand out, and that would not be such a good thing, isn't it? So, there's so much to it than we, you know, we are consciously thinking about it. Whether we are conscious, you know, making a conscious decision to go and get our, you know, go and put ourselves through this self-afflicted pain of, you know, facial hair removal or any kind of hair removal, you know, dyeing your your skin sometimes and you know, applying makeup and getting rid of all the, you know, pubic hair, even, you know, armpit, waxing of armpit, waxing of pubic hair, all of that is so much painful. And still we are doing that because, you know, if we don't do that, we will stand out and that would not be such a good thing. So, with my own experience, like I usually talk about things that I have experienced in my own life. So I'm going to completely talk about things that I have experienced and how I look at it now, how I have evolved through time. So till the time when I was in boarding school, class 12th, I was just, you know, I've never bothered about how I look, how my hair looks, how anything looks, because I was too much into studying and getting that rank that everyone wanted me to get. So the problem started when I entered into college and I saw that, oh my god, there are so many beautiful women out there and I look normal, I look below normal. So I started growing my hair and I started, you know, for the first time shaping my eyebrow. And then after a few years, I even went for, you know, waxing my underarm, the hair in my underarms. And I haven't yet, you know, done the removal of hair on my hands or legs because I haven't, and thank God I haven't. So, but there, most women nowadays, even men, one of my friends was telling me his experience of getting, you know, his chest hair waxed and removed. And it was so painful that halfway through he made a promise to himself that he will never ever do that, no matter what. So it is painful getting, you know, that is so much cruel to yourself, not to the world, but yourself, getting your, you know, putting all that wax and doing that. And even, you know, threading with thread, removal of your upper lip hair or eyebrows, shaping it is also very painful, and still each one of us go through it. So if you look closely, my eyebrows are not so much in shape, still in shape, but all these are extra hair that are growing, and I have to, you know, get rid of them because I'm going on a trip couple days after today. But I think I'm not going to do that this time because I'm already in so much pain. And the fact that, you know, okay, so let me go back to the story. So all these things with time, looking at the world, how world is, you know, getting into the version of a socially acceptable version of being a woman, I grew my hair, I started using makeup, I started using lipstick, kajal, skin whitening products, and till very lately, like even before, I think 6 months back when I got rid of my long hair, I was doing all that, and I thinking that, you know, I'm very pretty, I'm very beautiful that way. But Now, when I look back at that, look back at my Facebook pictures, on which there are hundreds of likes and comments and love reactions to, oh my god, you look so beautiful, I feel offended, because that's not me. This is who I am. I have not put anything now, anything actually, any product on my face or anywhere to look beautiful. So this is who I am, and I am beautiful. Whether you like it or not, this is me, and this is beautiful the way that I am. So 6 months back, I got rid of all my, you know, most of my hair. I actually wanted to go bald, really, for like, I'm not kidding. I really wanted to go bald, but that would be a lot of, you know, a lot of change at once. So I did not do that. And since that time, since last 6 months, I have short hair, because even this is not short. I want to, you know, I'm like, a week down the line, I will get rid of all that, this hair and all that, because I don't like hair. Yeah, that's true. I don't like hair at all, my hair, because it is too much work and it is too much pain, too much effort. So with my friend, I'm going to the men's salon this time and asking, like, going to ask them to shave everything from the back and leave only a little of front hair. So that is what is going. Okay, so I think I got distracted. So this is my story, and I'm still learning to love myself the way that I was born, the way that I am. And so I am a summer girl. I love, you know, I love summer. I love sunshine. So I love sitting in sunshine. And you girls and like men and women, every one of you know that if you are sitting in sunshine for about 30 minutes, there will be a difference in your skin complexion from here, like below where you are not wearing clothes. So earlier it used to, you know, disturb me like a lot that I am not... when I did not have a sun protection on or socks and all that on, I used to feel uncomfortable that when I go back to my room, I will have different skin tones. But now I go and sit there without a care in the world, because I don't really care. I love myself and I love the way I am. Let there be a different skin tone here and below my dress. So let it be. And even men, like people call them my partners, they will have to like me the way I am. They will have to like the lighter skin tone under my dress and, you know, darker skin tone of all the parts that are exposed to sun. Because I love sun, and sun gives me vitamin D. Sun gives me a lot of strength and encouragement to live my life. I'm going to go out there and sit without any sun protection on, without anything. It is actually good for your health too. So all these things, it took a lot of time. I am 25 now. It took me 25 years to unlearn all those things that were you know, shoved down our throat, shoved on our face, that, you know, you have to, a girl has to have long hair, a girl has to, you know, be silent and be very humble, be very sweet and all of that. No, a girl should not cuss and all that. So let us not go down that line, because I hope you get what I'm talking about. I have made a few bullet points of what I am going to talk. So just give me a second. Okay, so also for I read a book called Vagina Monologues. It was a beautiful book where the author Eva Esther, I think her name was, she has written beautifully about vaginal hair, like pubic hair. It is beautiful, the wild hair, and yeah, women should not, you know, shave it just because their men want them to look, you know, more younger. When that hair is not there, it is very degrading to women also, objectifying them and putting them, you know, in a shape. Like, you have to have a particular figure, and you have to, you know, have a particular skin tone, lighter skin tones, and all of that bullshit. So for all the men and women who are watching this, who are sexually active, you don't have to, you know, shave any kind, any pubic hair, any chest hair, any armpit hair, for the sake of, you know, looking younger and looking a certain way, you are beautiful the way you are. Your wild hair down there, all of those things are beautiful, and that makes you you. So please stop doing that. Stop afflicting pain on your own body just for the sake of stupidity. So also, I hope you know that earwax, mucus in nose, and you know, hair, pubic hair, armpit hair, all of them are there for a reason, to, you know, protect us from infections and all of those things, wounds, injuries and all. So they're there for a reason, and the society has been stupid, you know, putting the stupidity on you, and you have been taking it without, you know, questioning it. So question everything, start questioning, and stop, you know, taking down whatever is being shoved down on you by other people. So when women, okay, so I was talking about this with my friend today, Shubham, and we were talking about it, and he was like, you know, since all women try to put makeup and, you know, look normal, look pretty, we also cannot tell them that, you know, we like that version. So we want to, you know, we also want to encourage everybody to grow let your eyebrows become unibrow, okay? Because if you don't know, if I don't, you know, let my eyebrows naturally grow, it will become a unibrow. These hair will appear here too. Kajol was very famous for unibrow, by the way. So his point was, everybody, all girls are trying to look pretty. So how do I contribute to, you know, making them feel normal in their own skin? So the point is, you try and, you know, tell them that you look beautiful the way you are, and that's how the women who have internalized all this without questioning will try to shed that, and will try to, you know, be comfortable in their skin, like I am trying to learn. So losing weight, getting bikini wax, any kind of wax, and also getting, you know, for men it is a very big problem, we are not talking about it, it is a taboo, but hair, head full of hair is acceptable. A head without hair, bald head, is not acceptable. Stop, drop that bullshit. You look beautiful with or without hair. So seriously, I want to go bald, and I will go, I think, somewhere down the line, because I hate my hair. So some men who go bald naturally, who cannot grow, have to, you know, live their life in so much pressure, whether they should buy a wig or go for hair transplant, which is so painful again. So you don't have to do any of that. You are beautiful the way you are, no matter what the society has been telling you for centuries. And this last point is for all the women in the world, all the beautiful women in the world, the way you are, the way I'm sitting now, the way you are, no matter what skin tone you have, no matter whether you are tanned or not, how big your hip or breasts or whatever your shoulders are, you are beautiful the way you are. Please understand that. So these cosmetic products that we so mindlessly, you know, you are using, all the skin whitening products have mica in them. And for mica, in Jharkhand, children are killed. Thousands of children are being killed during child labor, 4 to 6 years. So almost every skin product has that. So please don't use, please don't, stop using all that bullshit. And mostly, like, lipsticks, hair conditioners, all of that are done, you know, are obtained by animal cruelty. Many animals are killed for, you know, slaughtered just to make, you know, obtain these cosmetic products. So little by little, start stopping the use of cosmetic products. You are beautiful the way you are. And your hair is beautiful, your facial hair, everything is beautiful. Please ever, never, never ever stop being comfortable the way you are. So, you're beautiful. Thank you. Thank you for watching.